Coming up on the show,
all access coverage of the CIAA Indoor Track and Field Championship.
How did our Rams do?
We'll have all of the highlights.
Plus our Ram of the Week interview. Who could it be?
Let's just say we jumped at the chance.
So keep it here.
Ram Sports is next.
Welcome back to Ram Sports. I'm E.
And I'm Jay.
And we're
E and Jay.
How you been doing, Jay?
I've been doing good, pretty much, you know. Been living life, taking day by day, step by step, hour by hour, minute by minute.
You look real sharp today.
Appreciate it, my buddy. You know, I got to stay clean, you know, stay clean. So, this week, track.
Tell me about it.
Ooh, CIAA Championship, man.
Zoom, zoom, zoom.
CIAA Championship at the JDL Fast Track. Woo-hoo. It's a good one, man. It's a good one. So, have you ever ran track?
I did, man. I ain't never liked the 400. I was a 100, man. That was it with me.
You was 100. Well, I ran hurdles. I also did field. I did long jump, triple jump. When I went to college for track. They wanted me to do multi, but I don't know what was they thinking, because multi was a lot.
See,
a lot.
I knew track wasn't for me when they said run the 600, and that about.
You said run the 600.
Mm-hmm. For practice, I ain't like that.
Okay. You almost lost me right there, because I never heard of an event called the 600 in track, but practice, we talking about practice? Practice. That's crazy. Practice was kind of heavy, you know. But let's get to the prelims, you know.
Run it.
Yeah.
The first day of the meet was a time for preliminaries.
Amik Willis made a mark qualifying for both the 60-meter dash and the 60-meter hurdle finals. More from Amik later in the show.
But now let's go to that classic run, the one-mile run. Reporter PJ Griffin has all the action.
So, Raven, you was finishing strong during the women's long mile run. How do you feel about your performance?
I feel awesome. I feel like I did really good.
What did you do to prepare for the event?
I practiced on my own really hard on my off days, and I did some new warm-ups before I started.
Well, here's again. This is Raven Farrell. She done did the women's long mile run. Keep doing your thing. Go Rams. Vanessa, you finished first in the women's mile run. How do you feel about your performance?
I feel really good. It was hard, but it was good. It was good. I'm very proud of myself. So tell me,
what was going through your mind during the event?
I would say trying to stay in front because all the girls were very competitive. They're really good, and we were all bunched together. So I was just thinking, like, I need to stay in front. I don't need to settle back. I just need to go and not turn back. So. Yeah.
So here again, this is Vanessa Jones, finished first in the women's mile long run. Keep doing your thing, go Rams. For sure.
Way to go, Vanessa, a big win early for the Rams.
But that's not all. The high jump was another event where the Rams soared over the competition.
Let's go back to PJ Griffin in the high jump area.
Let's jump.
What's going on, Ramley? This your boy P. June. We down here at the JDL Fast Track to watch your WSSU track team. Hey, Kennedy, she first for the high jump. Let's go talk to her. Kennedy, you got some ups. How you feel about your performance?
I feel like I did pretty good. I just had to redeem myself from freshman year, you know what I'm saying? Like, I came in as first place in the conference, and then I ended up in third. So now coming in first and coming out first, you know, I feel really good about it.
So what are we doing to prepare for tomorrow events?
Just make sure I drink a lot of water, get a lot of rest, and just make sure I eat healthy. Like, I'm not going to lie, I don't eat healthy all the time, I'm not going to lie. But just make sure you get some sleep, drink some water, a lot of water.
Nah, that's what I need to do too. But look, hey, keep doing your thing. For sure, thank you for this interview. Go Rams, for sure.
Kennedy Alexander took home another big win for the Rams in the high jump.
Kennedy was named CIAA Field Athlete of the Year at the award ceremony held at the end of the championships. Plus, she owns the CIAA women's record in the high jump at 1.71 meters.
But the Rams aren't only good at jumping high. They can also jump far.
Let's see how our ladies Rams leap in the long jump competition.
What's up, Rams? So I'm here with the one and only Tionna Wilson. She did her thing today in the long jump.
I heard that you had your best jump so far this season. How is that?
It feels really good. Really surprised me today as well. I didn't think I was going to jump what I jumped today, but it feels really great to PR this season.
Okay. So now that's day one. Do you got any events for day two?
Oh, yeah, I do. Day two is going to be triple jump, at least personally for me. And then we get into finals for some of the other athletes that's going to be running tomorrow.
Okay, well, you're here, folks. Now, she got an event on day two, so stay tuned for it. Now, be ready. Now, can we throw up the dub for him? Mm-hmm. Let's throw up the dub for him.
The dub, the ram. Yeah, you know that. Yeah. Hey, Elijah. I really enjoy covering the long jump. You should have been there.
Yeah, I missed it, Jay. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm giving you a second chance because after the break, we'll have one of our own long jumpers right here in the studio as our Ram of the Week.
Who will it be, Jacory?
You just have to stay tuned and find out
next.
Welcome back, Rams.
As promised, our Ram of the Week.
She got the butterfly locks, the Ram hoodie. It's Miss Tionna Wilson. So, let's talk about your events. So, I heard, actually, I didn't hear, I was there. I saw that you placed fourth in long jump, third in triple jump. So, tell me how you feel about that.
Well, I know at the beginning, I was kind of doing my thing. I was scratching a lot in both of my long and triple jump. So my confidence kind of started to lower, like really, really bad. After talking to my coach, he kept encouraging me, kept motivating me to do better. So when I ended up making it to the finals, I was like, okay, I got three more chances. I was placed pretty low in both long and triple jump at the beginning, but with that motivation, and all that confidence coming back and even praying to God, I ended up getting fourth in long and then third in triple.
Okay.
Good, good. Okay. So, Miss Wilson, where did you find your track passion at?
When I was little, I always wanted to run. I was never really influenced by my parents at all. My mom, she ran hurdles, but she wasn't really big on telling me to, hey, you know, run track. I always wanted to run, so I waited until my seventh grade year to be on the track team, and then I just stuck with it ever since.
Took off, okay.
Okay, so did you ever, like, did running events?
I have. At the beginning, I actually was just a sprinter. I would do, like, 100s all the way to 400s, and this was before I actually became a jumper, actually. I was actually pretty good at the time, or pretty decent, depending on, you know, the circumstances. And my events before I actually went into my jumps. I started off as being a jumper my freshman year in high school, and at that time I was a high jumper before I became a long and triple.
Okay, okay. So before I continue this interview, I just want to say this. The mind is something special. So when you think about something, you do it. So when you think about, oh, I'm going to get this amount of distance, you will do it if you think it. And so don't ever let your mind play tricks on you. So don't ever think that you can't do nothing. You are a great person. You can jump. So don't ever let your mind stop you from doing anything. You know, trick your mind. Think positive before you think negative. Because when you think negative, you're going to do negative. So when you do think positive, you're going to do positive. Mm-hmm. So keep that in mind. And back to all this other stuff about the track. How do you feel about being here in Winston on the track team?
Actually, I feel pretty great, actually. Of course, there's going to be ups and downs with people, but that's life. In the end, we are still a family, and we still cheer on for each other no matter what. Now, of course, we're basically like sisters. We're going to bump heads. We're not going to always get along. But at the end of the day, we always work with each other. We always have this bond where it's unbreakable. And as you can see, you saw that at the CIAA championships. No matter what, even when we didn't get first place overall, we still did our chance. We still kept going. We still kept cheering. And we still had our heads up because outdoor, we're going to see our competition again. And true. No matter what, we're not going to give up. Because honestly, we the big dogs.
Big dogs, yeah. Hold on, y'all not the big dogs. Y'all the big Rams. Big Rams.
So, how did you get here to Winston?
So, I actually got here, mainly I was being recruited for track. And I was looking at different schools before Winston. To be honest, Winston wasn't on my list at the time. I was kind of looking for like a Division I at the time. But I had a really deep connection with the coaches at Winston and then the atmosphere of Winston. Compared to other like other universities, even though they had, you know, the supplies or, you know, everything else, it still felt like there was like a bond here compared to the others. So that's what made me choose Winston.
That's the SU atmosphere.
Okay, well, I appreciate you taking the time to come out here and do this interview. And good luck to you on the outdoor seat.
Yes.
But that's our time for right now for the interview.
This is Ms. Wilson.
And next up is the Pentathlon, where another Ram did pretty well for herself. No spoilers, though.
On your mark.
Energy is there. Team spirit is there. Everybody's coming together.
Another event where we put in a strong showing is the shot put. Let's toss it up to the team. Go Rams. Rams.
So I'm here with
Demaya.
Ariana.
Alyssa. Asia.
So they throw shot put. Okay, so tell me how you feel about it.
Right now, I feel good, but at the same time, I feel like I could have done better, but it's just a good feeling.
I'm just very proud and happy all of us, you know, made finals, but again, it's a lot to work on, and I can just see, like, what I need to work on and focus on.
I'm happy. I could have done better, but I'm happy about all of us making it to finals.
We could have did better, all of us.
I think y'all did a wonderful job, though. Y'all all made it to the finals. Okay, so how y'all feeling about the whole championship?
Obviously, WSSU runs CI. We about to get that ring, but we also going to get another ring in outdoor. So stay tuned.
It's about to be a repeat.
Just proud of my team.
Oh, she got her Marshawn Lynch going on. She just proud of her team. But y'all hear it, folks. They about to get this ring. So stay tuned.
A strong finish by the Rams shot put team. Second, third, fourth, and eighth.
All more points that add up to our overall team score. Now we'll come to two events that wrapped up the meet.
First, the longest individual race for the women, the 3,000-meter run.
It takes a strategy to run this race, when to set the pace, and when to kick it.
So, I see that y'all just got done running it. Was it 3,000? How you feel about it?
I feel amazing. I am proud of myself. And yeah, I just feel really good. I feel really good.
I'm also really proud. We finished the race. We finished out strong, and the team did really well.
Another big win for the Rams in the 3,000-meter run. And now we come to the last event of the day.
At the end of the long two-day meet, is there any gas left in the Rams tank for the 4x400 relay? Ladies, start your engines.
So I'm here with the 4x4. They just did their thing. Sadly, they came in second, but they still did their thing. So how y'all feeling?
You know, I feel great. I feel empowered. Like, we could do it again, but better. You know what I'm saying?
I feel very proud of my team. We went out and we fought.
It was a tough race, and we did our best.
Yeah, we all did our best, so I'm proud of everybody.
We took home second in the 4x400 relay.
And those additional points earned, the Rams a very solid second place finish at the 2022 CIAA Indoor Track and Field Championships.
Although Fayetteville State finished first, let's just take a moment and enjoy the moment at the Rams got their second place trophy.
I love that team spirit, and more good things are coming our way.
Right you are, E. After the awards, I talked with the head coach, Antonio Wells, about the meet and a look ahead at the future competition.
So I'm here with the head coach. So coach, how you feeling right now?
It's been a good 2 days. I can honestly say I'm very proud of every last thing these young ladies have done in these past couple days. It's been a tough three weeks, to be honest, with the weather and everything going on with COVID. But they came in and gave everything they had.
The new season coming up of the outdoor, what can the team improve on?
So we have more throwing events coming in outdoor. We have discus and javelin, and that's going to give our throwers a pretty good advantage. I want to say our throwers, they got 20 points out of the shot put alone, and that's a big number for us. So with other throws coming in, we have the 400 hurdles coming in, where Meek Willis is a pretty strong athlete in that.
Well, you hear it, folks. Now, be prepared for the outdoor season, because we're coming.
My thanks to Coach Wells and Coach Pridgen. They gave us access to the team and events during the CIAA Indoor Championship.
And it looks like we can expect even more wins from the women's track and field team in the future.
You know, E, one thing I realized watching the Rams compete.
What's up, Jay?
It's not just all about winning. There's something more to being a Ram. Can't put a name on it, but I'd like to show you a little something. As we close out the show for Ram Sports, I'm Jay.
And I'm E.
Roll it.
'Cause one, you're like a dream.